Hello dear students, today we have to discuss about a new topic. The topic name is biological pest control method. It is the new method and very important pest control method that generally used to different natural enemies or biological control agents. So dear student, here some picture I am showing you, that a ladybird beetle, it's one chalcid wise or fly, greenless wing, and the last one is a wasp. So these are the all natural enemies that occur in environment, and its role to minimize the pest population naturally without any that interference of man. So this insect are naturally controlled this all sucking pest, even some larva, some borers. Naturally, that they all are controlled. So the first of all, so the what is mean by biological control method? So actually, the successful management point of the pest by means of the what may be the another living organism that available in environment, they are used to destruction or suppression or regulation purpose, but or that undesirable insect, even other animals or some weed plants, by the use of introduction or its encouragement, or by the artificially release or increase of their natural enemies to minimize the pest, so called as the biological control method. So here some different types of strategy of biological control, so the like predation, parasitism, and other natural mechanism used to minimize the pest outbreaks, resurgence, and what may be the resistant development in insect. Through this, be using this naturally bio agents that control properly. So dear student, here some are the biological control agents: predator, parasitoid, pathogenic microorganism like bacteria, fungi, nematodes, protozoa, and viruses. Here that picture that we can see here, generally the ladybird beetle that feeds on the aphid. Here one larva that affected or that parasitized by parasitoid wasp. Okay, the last picture here, the some pathogen like bacteria, fungus, and viruses. Here that totally that the pathogenicity occur or causing disease on insect body. So these are the all naturally bioagents used to minimize or to control the different type of pest. So dear student, first of all we have to discuss about the what is mean by predator. Predator, it is nothing but it is a one organism or free living species that directly consume a large number of prey during their whole life span or lifetime or for the completion of life cycle. Here the one bugs that destroy the larva and to feed on them, so that is the predator. So example is ladybugs, particularly their larva are predators. Okay, and to feeds on aphid and also consume many small insect like mites, scale insect, leafhopper, jacinth, like that insect feed by this predator. Another example also the predators like praying mantids, okay, ruderate bug, dragonfly also, these are all that comes under the predator category. So dear students, so next one strategy about the parasitoid. Parasitoid, its definition is any insect parasite of an arthropod that is parasitic in its immature stages and killing the host in the process of development or in the process of completion of life cycle. And adults are generally free living, so called as a parasitoid. Here the example I am showing you, okay, this chalcid wasp or this trichogramma wasp sitting on that host eggs and laying the eggs inside the eggs of host. Student, understand properly, here the host eggs means the it's a lepidopteran host, like any butterfly or that moth or bollworm commonly, that will what may be the lay the eggs. This trichogramma was lay the eggs inside, and finally the host eggs are destroyed. Here that incarcia species, apatis species, even telenoma species and Aplinus mali species, and here also the one larva, spongid moth larva, are totally affected by this parasitoid. So this white tissue parasitoid and this greenish color in larva are the host, commonly called as the parasitic in nature, what may be the insect called as the parasitoid. Now what is the, or which are these different techniques or methods of biological control? Here the first method is importation, second one augmentation, and third one conservation. Student, here the picture I am showing you, that we can see clearly here the biological control agent, and here the some pest species, sorry, and these are the what may be the insect are established properly called as this importation or introduction. Here the inoculation that comes under this inoculation and immunity comes under in augmentation. Here the few numbers of the species of biogens we have to release and properly introduce. Finally, what may be the progeny that comes to destroy. Okay, immunity that at the initial requirement that to feeding purpose of the host insect, that is called it. So in next slide, here the importation is means nothing but it is also called as a introduction or also called as a classical biological control. So dear student, the meaning about this classical biological control or importation. So what may be the introduction and establishment of natural enemies to a new location where the this type of the natural enemies they do not occur naturally, but did not occur naturally and originated naturally. When natural enemies are successfully established, okay, and it is usually continues to control the pest population called as importation. Okay, so called as a importation. Example of this example of this importation here, one of the earliest success in West was in controlling Icaria purchasi. Okay, this Icaria purchasi is a cottony cushion scale in Australia, and using a predatory insect called as a Rhodalia cardinalis. Student, this cottony cushion scale is a pest. Suppose in case the for this controlling of this cottony cushion scale insect, we require this type of the Vedalia beetle that commonly called as the Rhodalia cardinalis. So this insect when introduced or that to import from the other country to controlling of this the introduced pest, so this type called as the importation. Second example here mentioned on wasp, so that trichogramma, so this to control European corn borer. Trichogramma is a natural enemies that is parasitoid to minimize the pest of European corn borer, known as the importation. Now the next one, augmentation. It involves the supplementary release of natural enemies or boosting the naturally occurring population. Here the meaning of augmentation, it is a rearing, okay, or the releasing of natural enemies as a supplement, okay, and finally there are the two approaches of the augmentation. Okay, here that all activities designed or to increase number to effect or to effect existing natural enemies achieved by releasing additional number of any natural enemies into a system, or that too we have to modify the environment in such a way as to promote and to greater number of its effectiveness or to for the proper minimizing of the pest population. This augmentation are in the two types. The first is this the inoculative release, and second one is a inundative release. Inoculative release means what, the small numbers of the control agents are released at intervals. Okay, so that called as a inoculative release. When this type of this releasing to reproduce in the hope of to setting up a longer term control and thus keeping the pest down at a low level, and this type of this releasing called as the inoculative release. Here the example is the greenhouse. If you that production of different crops. Okay, and if we periodically release of the parasitoid that mentioned that Encarsia formosa are used to control the greenhouse whitefly. For the space of controlling of this greenhouse whitefly, here the Encarsia is we have to periodically release. Second example here in the same greenhouse, that two predatory mites that commonly known as the Phytophthalus persimilis, it's a natural enemy and it is used to control the spider mites. Okay, so that's called as the inoculative release. Now the inundative release, it involves the mass culture and mass multiplication and release of natural enemies when the population that approaches that damaging level. So that time the natural enemies are not expected to reproduce, okay, but to increase number, and control is achieved through the release individual. So called as a inundative release. Example about this inundative release is what may be the massive release of trichogramma in vegetable or any field. So that that required rate is a 5,000 to 2 lakh per acre per week, that according to level of the pest infestation. And during that, to releasing this trichogramma, that result or that control is achieved through this releasing time called as inundative release. So dear student, the last techniques about this conservation, it is defined as action to preserve and to release the natural enemies, okay, by the environmental manipulation, or we have to that to protect the natural enemies. They are already present in an area, or due to the non-use of those pest control measures that destroy the natural enemies. So we have to implement that the proper control practices and to conserve these natural enemies. So here that some conservation involves that avoidance of like harmful cultural practices, okay, that harm to the some natural enemies, that we have to minimize this type of the harmful practice. Second one is a maintenance of diversity. Properly we have to maintain its different kinds of this species and its diversity. Habitat manipulation practices, providing suitable habitat or shelter. Natural food, we have to conserve it. If not available the natural food, we have to provide as a supplement artificial food, and to increase the population of its natural enemies. And its main purpose behind that to conservation, we have to need-based pesticide we have to apply. So how many types of what happen? Generally the harmful the pesticide, insecticide are the to destroy the natural enemies. So for this purpose, it gives the protection from the many harmful pesticide. So these are some major techniques and very important techniques in biological control method. So dear student, today hear this all detail about this biological control method. It's not a complete topic, it's a first part about this biological control, that predator, parasitoid and some pathogen and its techniques of biological control. This technique is very important for your examination point of view. In the onwards lecture about this biological control, we have to discuss about the remaining topic of biological control. Thank you. If anyone have doubt or query, so please message me on our group. Thank you.